Hey, it's Dr. Ko here from Reset Ketamine in Palm Springs, California, and I came across an interesting scientific article. I want to share it with you. It's titled Electrophysiological Correlates and Predictors of the Antidepressant Response to Repeated Ketamine Infusions in Treatment-Resistant Depression. This was published in Progress in Neuro-psychopharmacology and Biological Psychiatry in April 2022. All right, I probably said a bunch of words and a mouthful there, but this article was fascinating because they were measuring patients who were receiving ketamine with electrodes attached on their scalp, EEGs. And one of the interesting things they found was an increase in a specific type of brainwave. It's called gamma waves. And so we have alpha, beta, theta, delta waves that are, you know, part of our sleeping or waking consciousness. However, gamma waves was the one thing that they noticed. So I did a little bit of background research into gamma waves, and what they found is that gamma waves have been found when there's these long-term meditators getting into a deep meditative phase. They also enter the gamma wave phase. So could it be possible that ketamine is creating kind of a meditative experience for the patient, which is helping alleviate their depression? Multiple studies have shown that meditation can also be pretty effective for mood disorders like anxiety and depression. So maybe the ketamine is also altering the brainwave physiology by creating these gamma waves. Now, there was another interesting study. There was a patient who was getting an EEG. He was an elderly gentleman, and he was at the hospital while this was occurring. And as he was getting his EEG, he unfortunately passed away. But the unique contribution that this patient made to global society is that EEG pattern. So guess what type of EEG pattern that the patient had as he was literally passing away? Gamma waves. So some patients have reported a near-death-like experience as they're receiving ketamine. And yes, that can be scary. And sometimes it can be peaceful as well. Humans' greatest fear is the fear of death. What if someone was able to face their fear of death and feel calm and collected about it? What if you knew, hey, this is what dying is like, but thank God I am still alive. Thank God I'm still here. That would give you a renewed sense in your life. So the bottom line is that ketamine increases gamma wave activity in the brain, which has been linked to meditation and even the passing of someone's life. The fortunate thing is that when someone is receiving IV ketamine, they are being monitored, they're not going to die, all of the cardiovascular respiratory function is still in good order. But the experience can be quite awakening. Let me know what you think about this. Leave me any questions or comments, and please hit that like and subscribe button below so that you can stay tuned to the next video. I'll catch you next time.